Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Whale Nerds Podcast. This is mini episode number 13. My name is Slater, and I'm here with Caitlin.
Hello.
And we're doing a little mini episode. We got some host updates.
Yes.
Caitlin's going to hit you with those.
Okay. Well, I'm going to Maui, so by the time this episode comes out, I will be there.
Woo!
Yeah, so we're recording this in advance before I...
And I will
go through
be.
All the madness.
Sadly.
Yeah, I don't know if you're going to be able to swing a Maui trip this year. You got too many things planned.
Yeah, no, I don't think so.
But then also just some other updates for Whale Nerds. We do have our spring trips available online for Monterey for April. So if you want to come whale watching with us, we're going to be looking for humpback whales, possibly gray whales, but also possibly killer whales, blue whales, dolphins, cool seabirds, sharks, and who knows?
And judging how last April went, it can only go up from there, I would think.
I mean, our trips were...
We saw killer whales.
Really
luckily.
Good compared to how the rest of April went.
Yeah. So, lucky trip dates, but... I think that it could definitely, it's going to be even better next year. So,
yeah. And we are going to do a beach cleanup again for Earth Day during that weekend. We'll have more details available as the date gets closer, but just kind of keep that in mind as well. The beach cleanup will be free, open to the public. So even if you don't go on the boat or if you come with a group and not everybody goes on the boat, you can all come to the beach cleanup. So we'll keep you posted on that. And then you can also just stay tuned on everything we're doing by following along on our website. We have a blog up there. We have our merch there, and it's thewhalenerds.com. And you can always check that out and keep up to date with what we're doing. And then another good way to stay connected to us is social media or following along on YouTube, because all our video episodes from 100 onwards are available on there. And sometimes we post other stuff on there, and then all of it is under the handle at Whale Nerds. YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, they're all under the same handle. So, yeah.
Yeah. And also, we really need to thank our Patreon supporters because
yes.
I feel like we haven't thanked them in a couple episodes because they've been a little scrambled.
Yes.
But thank you so much for supporting us on Patreon. Some of you have supported us for like a couple years now, I feel
yeah.
like. So,
you're yeah. our heroes.
Thank you so much for the support. And thanks for listening and following along and just checking out our social media posts. And also thanks for anyone that's rated and reviewed the podcast over the years too. It means a lot to us.
Yes. Thank you. I mean, normally we do like some stuff for like the week of Thanksgiving, sharing our gratitude, but this year it was just like way too many things happening.
Moving.
Personally. Yeah. So I apologize for that. It doesn't mean I'm any less grateful. But
I'm not grateful.
No, I'm super grateful. You guys make this. This is why we do it, so that people can learn about whales and share excitement with us. And, you know, thanks for following along with us while we throw this into the universe.
Make it up as we go along.
Pretty much. So we're going to make up some science from interesting stuff on Happy Whale for this episode.
Yes.
Pretty much. Okay, so before the end of my season in Monterey, we had some interesting humpback sightings. And when I pulled the Happy Whale information for the whales on the boat, I was like, what is happening? Like, I really wanted to share it on the podcast. So I didn't get any photos of this whale in particular, but there were photos taken of that whale on that day. It's a whale named Tornado. It was like pretty rough out and the deck was really slippery. So upstairs I was like narrating, but also like catching people as they were moving back and forth across the deck. So I just like, I'm not even getting my camera out, but it's a humpback whale that's pretty well known named Tornado. And if you look at Tornado's Happy Whale information, which I'll put in the Facebook comments, let me pull it up here. Of course, now I'm moving my screen.
I saw this whale. I'm a sider.
yeah, it's seen a lot in Monterey.
I remember this whale.
It's been seen since 2017 in California, and it's had 26 sightings in California. But then, pull up the map. Where did it go last winter?
2008, it was in Was it in Maui? Let me see. Hold on. Yeah, off of Maui. The tornado one. Off of Lahaina. Yeah.
Last winter, it went to Maui.
It was seen in 2008. Wow.
Yeah, February 8th of this 2022. Year. Yeah, dang. So last winter season.
So
isn't
it
that
just
wild?
It makes no sense. Do you know what, though?
It does what it wants.
Well, also, they could get lost.
I don't know. I mean, Hawaii is a pretty specific place to get lost.
I know, but if their GPS gets, like, you know, like, their magnet gets all messed up and they turn right.
That's like 45 degrees the wrong direction. Can your magnet really get that messed up?
Yes. What if they went the opposite way and went over to the Philippines?
Dude, that'd be crazy. What if it went to Japan?
Yeah.
There's a breeding ground over there. So I don't
That's
know.
That's what we don't know. Is anybody happy whaling in Japan?
I think they're starting to. Pack Whale's working on a collaborative thing with them over there. So hopefully they'll get some more buy. I'm sure they're doing their own cataloging. They just may not be connected to Happy Whale yet.
Dang. But I mean, can you imagine? It's like, this whale's been seen here, there, and there.
That would be nuts. I feel like a whale that goes to like Russia, Alaska, or like Northern Canada, though, would be like the most likely to go to the other side of the Pacific, Hawaii, and to the eastern side of the Pacific. Right? Like, because it's easier to set your course from up there and end up at one of those.
Dang. Oh, I love humpbacks.
And then, like, the thing with tornado is, we don't know if that whale like swam down to Mexico first, didn't get sighted, and then swam across. I mean, it was sighted in February, so it probably just went straight there. But like, you know, when you pull the Happy Whale map, it's kind of like, is a little bit of an illusion because it's just connecting the GPS locations with straight lines, even though that's not the path the whale probably took.
When was the first time it was seen here or seen on California this year?
That's 2022. So if you go to the column display and you click the date to put them in order, it was seen in California in April.
Yeah, there we go.
So probably pretty much came straight back from Maui.
March, 8th. Yeah, 2 months.
Yeah, so it's 8 weeks.
That's like a long swim. You think that's a 2 month crossing?
Yeah, I think so.
If it's like 5,000 miles, right?
I think it's probably more like
3,000 miles to Maui.
I don't know.
Okay, guess, so anyways, yeah, 3,000 miles, they go to 3 to 6 miles per hour.
Yeah, they cover like 75 to 100 miles a day.
Yeah, so it's a lot of days.
Yeah.
Man, imagine if humans are like, oh, I got to get to New York. I'm just going to walk there for the next. I guess it's a migration of humans.
I mean, when I took that boat down the coast, you could have probably walked there just as fast as the boat got there. It took 32 days to go from Massachusetts to Florida.
Do you think that humans were like, do you think at one point we kind of, well, for sure we probably did, I guess we were like hunter gatherers, but we basically stopped working during the winter. Like we didn't stop working, but we slowed down and did other things.
Well, when we were farmers, I think, yeah, when we started to grow crops, but when we were hunting, we had to keep moving south and follow food.
True. All right, that makes sense.
When
we had like,
established like, places to live.
Personally, and I probably a lot of people feel the same, is like every I think it's just because the whale seasons change, but in the winter I tend to slow down my activity level a lot. I was thinking, I wonder if like the human race should just take a break during the winter as a whole. You know,
we should everybody calm down
still till next season. No, we have way too many things going
on. Our stupid capitalistic society won't allow it. Anyways, okay, so tornado. Where's that whale going to go this winter? I don't know. Guess we'll find out. So if you want to follow that whale on Happy Whale and get updates, it's a pretty interesting whale to kind of keep tabs on. And it has a pretty cool marking on the left side of the fluke. So even though I didn't take a photo, like Kate recognized it without even like running it through the whale matcher. She was just like, oh, it's tornado. So.
Huh. She had seen it before here?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and its tail's pretty distinct, which is cool.
Yeah, it is cool.
So The other whale that we saw, like, not long after we saw Tornado, is this humpback whale named Dancer. And listeners up in the Pacific Northwest will know Dancer because that whale is also regularly seen in Washington and British Columbia.
I don't know if I saw this whale.
Looks it's got familiar. A pretty big entanglement mark on the right side of the tail, and then it has some marks on its back too. I don't know if there's any photos submitted of the back, but I remember taking photos of the back.
I wonder why they called it Dancer. Maybe it was like waving its fluke around or something.
Yeah, there's no comment in Happy Whale as to why it's called that. But I'm pretty sure it got that name up north.
Yeah, you know, it looks, doesn't that white marking kind of look like a molar on top?
A molar? A
tooth? It looks like a tooth. Or on one of the first photos I saw of it that I'm clicking onto, it kind of looked like an I, like just a, like the letter I, like a lowercase
yeah,
I.
Yeah, it does look like a lowercase I.
Yeah. So.
I don't know, maybe it
or
looks
maybe
like
it's a torch
dancing.
Maybe it's like the flame of a torch. Oh.
I don't know.
So it was a New York whale.
So if you pull up the Happy Whale data and you go to like the middle display where it's like the columns with the dates,
mm-hmm.
put the dates in order. You can see this whale move up and down the coast every year. So it's been seen since 2019. So like this year, its first sighting was in April, the beginning of April. It was in California all the way until the end of the month. So April 30th, it was seen in California. Then August 30th, it was seen in Washington. So it moved up the coast all spring and summer. Then it was seen in British Columbia right after that. And it kind of like stayed up in, like bounced back and forth for, it looks like a day between Washington and British Columbia. And then was up in British Columbia for September. And then by the end of October, it was back down in California.
Dang. This whale gets around. That we actually...
And if you put
it in
order, you can
see
that it moves in the spring and fall. It's in California. And then in the summer, it's up in Washington and British Columbia.
Yeah, it has so many sightings and different like that. You actually have to like make sure you move to the next page. I had to go down a page because I didn't realize. I wonder if it has. Dang. So in. Oh, my gosh, that's crazy.
Yeah,
that's a lot of movement. I could see
it
like
was seen Monterey. Even in December and November of 2020, it was in California.
Okay, that's a feeding ground crazy movement.
Yeah.
That whale's got something going on that it can't stop moving.
Well, and it doesn't have any breeding ground information.
Maybe it just doesn't go.
Could be. I mean.
Oh, is this the start of something new?
I don't know.
I really think that like there's. Okay, right now in the Bay, we had. I don't know. I'm just going to say there's over 10. We're seeing over 10 whales still. Mm-hmm. I feel like that's kind of a lot. Like just on the north side. That's not mm-hmm. counting whatever they're seeing down off of Carmel or Point Pinos or offshore little ways. Like there was probably more than that. I mean, I easily saw over 10 whales and there was more whales out west and Kate had found more whales. And so, I mean, that's a pretty good amount of whales for November or for December.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. Maybe some of them don't go. And a lot of them are juveniles and stuff, too.
Yeah. And I don't even know if you could say that Dancer's really that young because the first sighting is in 2019, but it's a decent-sized whale. And that entanglement scar has been healed and has looked like an old scar the whole time that whale has been seen. Yeah.
Yeah, so it's obviously you could say it was more than it's definitely more than 3 years old.
Yeah. So, you know, where has this whale been until 2019? I don't know.
I wonder if other whales in the history have been like started here. They were California, Mexico, and then they went up north one time and they were like, whoa, or they went to Maui. Well, yeah, I feel like it's more likely for them to go up north and then go down because they might meet a whale and keep, you know, cruise with it.
Yeah.
And they'd be like, nah, dude, I'm going to my own breeding ground.
I mean, what if this is dancer's migration? What if this whale just breeds in Monterey?
Dang like it.
Food, good looking other whales. What's not to like?
That's crazy.
The reason why I even bring it up is because when I came back from New York that day, there was a newborn calf seen in Monterey, humpback calf.
Yeah.
So were you on the water that day?
I was on the water and I don't remember what I was seeing, but we were having some good sightings. And then Danny called Bill found the calf.
Yeah.
And he's like, I'm telling you guys, this is the smallest calf I've ever seen. And then Danny ended up getting the drone up over it. And it was like absolutely tiny.
Yeah. I mean, I looked at the drone footage and there was still like fetal creases on the tail and the dorsal fin. And some of the other footage I saw from people was like really pretty curled up.
Yeah.
But the fluke was stiff. So my best guess is under a week old. So yeah. New baby. And that mom is not frequently sighted on Happywhale. Thank goodness someone got an ID.
Yeah.
Because
that's the first thing I thought.
Really interesting to be able to capture that. She's only been seen 14 times since 2019.
And she's having a calf. So it's like she's obviously older.
Yeah.
I don't get it, man. There's no rules.
Yeah, she's only been seen 14 times since 2009. Did I say that right? 2009. Yeah. So,
she's definitely old. Oh, you said 2019.
Yeah, excuse me. 2009. So,
she's really old.
Wow, dude.
Well, I'm just saying, like, compared to all the other humpbacks we've been seeing that are like first seen in the last 3 years.
Yeah. And like, she has really big gaps in her sighting information. So she was seen in 2009 in February in California. And then she wasn't seen again till 2012.
Yeah, where's she been going? But she could be going to Morro Bay, Half Moon Bay,
Big Sur,
Oregon.
I mean, her sighting rate, if you averaged it across years, is like less than once a year. But it's like she was seen in 2009. Then she was seen three times in 2018, all in August. Then she wasn't seen again till 2016. And it was like she was in California a lot in 2016. She was there in February.
Oh, she has a breeding ground.
Yeah, she was seen in Baja.
In 2016, okay. Okay, so maybe she'll get picked up down there this year.
Yeah, and then she wasn't seen. She had a gap from, let's see. Oh, no, she was
up
in.
You know what? This is a whale that's been seen off Newport multiple times.
Yes.
And so, you know what? I feel like whales that are there sometimes are weird. Well, I'm just saying, like, they are. They're like one-off whales that you never see. And they, like, come in and hang out for a little while, and then they leave. And I feel like there's a lot of whales that hang out behind all the Channel Islands that a lot of people
for sure.
See. Like,
for sure.
Ever.
So look at this 2016 data. So she's seen in Baja on December 20th. Then she's seen in Monterey on January 24th.
Dang.
That's pretty fast.
Some of these whales just swim.
And then she disappeared again all summer and wasn't seen again till October that year. And then from 2017, she wasn't seen again till 2020. Was only seen twice in 2020. Seen once in 2021. And then she was seen almost a year later in 2022 in Monterey with a newborn calf.
I kind of think that we need to like rewrite some books probably. And it's just like, it's like under the thing, it's like migration pattern. No rules.
Unknown.
No, just no rules. It's like, yeah, this is definitely a whale that goes to Costa Rica. And it's like, no, it's not.
Yeah.
It happened to go to Costa Rica two times.
Well, so my question is, which we should talk to the people down in like Banderas Bay or something. My question is, do a lot of the Central American and South Mexico whales stop in Baja or in Puerto Vallarta or something for like a day, and then they keep going south? Because there are some whales like bottlenose, I'm pretty sure she's been seen in like Banderas Bay, but she's also been seen down off Central America. Yeah, so she has like a sighting in Cabo. She has a sighting off Ixtapa. She has a sighting off El Salvador. So like, did she just stop in Cabo and then keep going down? Like, is that their normal pattern where Cabo ends up seeing both populations?
See, that's the thing is that's a good point, because how many of these whales are traveling and a whale watch boat's just going out there and the whale's there for the day or even an hour or 10 minutes is just going by and they follow it, get a fluke ID.
Yeah.
And then that whale's already 100, you know, 75 miles away the next day.
Like, yeah. Yeah. So then it's like,
is that like, why would they go way out and then in? Like, they're, of course, they're going to take the easiest route to get there.
Yeah. Cause the coastline hooks back in towards the east there. So, like, if you went straight down, you're going to be way offshore. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know. I mean, we should talk to somebody down in Mexico and see if they have any insight on that. Because then it's like, so bottlenose had a calf this year, right? But there, I don't think there was any breeding ground sightings for her. So it's like, well, where was that calf born?
We have to like look at.
She was seen in El Salvador in February, but I don't think it says. Seen with its calf. So the calf was born in El Salvador this year.
All the whales that are submitted down there, like that are seen during the breeding grounds, and see where else, and look at it that way and see where they've been seen.
Yeah, like pull the timeline or something instead.
Dang.
Yeah, I mean, what if they like need to rest for a day in Cabo or in Puerto Vallarta or something, and they just like
food.
Chill. Yeah.
Like, it's good fishing in Cabo during the winter. I'm just saying, like, if there's fishing, there's definitely food for them to eat. So
yeah.
Like, they have the sardine run in Magdalena Bay.
Yeah.
And all those striped marlin, and then the Pacific Whitesides are in there eating it too. And so I wonder if humpbacks, they definitely eat sardines. We know that for a fact. So it's mm-hmm. like, I wonder if they eat down in Mexico.
Yeah. So last winter in Maui, we had a bunch of opelu, which is like a little bait fish in the Hawaiian Islands, like big bait balls of it in Ma'alaya Bay. And the whales would like just swim through them and then just.
Oh, did they get footage of it?
They didn't. No, I mean, we have like topside footage that's not very good, but like they didn't look like they were eating it. They just look like they're swimming through it.
Guess what?
What?
Yesterday, no, 2 days ago, I was out whale watching, and Kate actually, so like we were just kind of going from group to group, and then Kate was like, Kate was out for fun.
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, I have a trio over here, Slater, but I'm not going to stay with them. And so I went over there. And then they started feeding, like with all these, there was like 1,000 Bonaparte gulls, and they were all like doing these murmurations and stuff. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And so anyways, they were feeding right below them. And this whale literally just like opens his mouth like that. You know,
like
that video
trap
of the
feeding
is
thing?
It the Brutus whale that has, yeah.
Yeah.
Is it Brutus or a say whale?
They're Brutus whales. The Birdie Gregory footage.
Yeah.
Or
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So like that, it just opened his mouth for a second and it was like kind of skimming like a right whale and then it just closed it. But it wasn't like none of the other whales lunge and it wasn't like a fast paced thing. It like literally just either it was just opening his mouth, but it looked like his feet. It was going right under those birds. All the birds were picking right there too. So yeah. I don't know.
Might have been doing a little bit of trap feeding. I've seen the whales in California like try it.
We also had two other humpback, a pair of humpbacks lunge feed too a couple times, which was awesome. So still surface feeding a little bit.
Yeah. I mean, when I looked up the hormone stuff about the friendly behaviors and like when the competition groups and stuff start, I mean, the other reason why I was looking that up is because I personally think there's some sort of hormone suppressant that happens during the winter season. Like, so that they don't feel as hungry, so they can focus on reproduction. You know what I mean?
Mm.
So, but I do know that, like, I'm pretty sure in Mexico they've seen them feed. We'll have to ask somebody down there. But like in Hawaii, yeah, I was so surprised. The bait balls looked huge and they like didn't go for it. So I feel like they must have like some biochemical thing going on to like suppress their appetite. Because otherwise, how could you be starving for like 4 months and like have that not distract you, you know?
They eat so much though.
Yeah.
But they burn a lot too, I guess, right?
Yeah. I mean, after a competition group, don't you think the males are like, all right, let's go find some food?
Nah, in Maui, they're like, let's go get a Mai Tai.
Yeah. But, you know, they want some poke.
Yeah. Maybe they just eat a couple tunas. You don't even notice.
But
that'd be so cool.
I mean, we'll see how it goes this year because there are newborns in Hawaii already, like several days after the one in Monterey was reported. I saw footage of newborns in Ma'alaya Bay in Maui. So it's like the middle of November and there's baby whales already. And then down in Mexico already, like at Cabo Trek and stuff, they're posting footage like it's January there.
Yeah.
There's so many whales there right now.
And I was just showing Margo on Instagram this morning, Hawaii ocean rafting. They had a bunch of nice encounters already too.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like, we used to say like, if the whale's born before Christmas, it's early. Mm. And these whales are born before December 1st. Like, what?
No rules.
Yeah.
They don't have rules.
So I don't know. Does that mean the whole season's going to like peak early? Or does that mean the season's going to be like weirdly like at high numbers the whole time?
I don't think it matters.
Be like two peaks. Like, I don't know what to expect for Maui this season.
I don't think it matters. I think every year is different no matter what. I don't think it's ever going to be the same. I don't think it's ever like perfectly like, okay, August 15th, there's going to be 100 whales in Monterey Bay. It's like, no, this year it was in May for some reason.
August 15th, there was like no humpback whales in Monterey Bay.
Yeah, like, but there was more whales in the spring, which is usually like not the case. So
yeah, I was talking to Katarina Oddly the other night about that too, about how the summer was kind of weird. And she's like, in southern Mexico, she's like, our whale watch season, according to our permit, doesn't even start till December 15th. And she's like, we've had whales there for weeks already.
Oh, they can't go yet?
Yeah. So it's like, what do? Do you revise the permit or do you just wait? You know, like she's like, it's so weird. Like, it's definitely taken us by surprise.
You got to be ready for humpbacks at any time.
Yeah. But how do you place. Like when you have a permit system, like how do you manage that?
Also, you know? Like, not very many people are IDing humpbacks in Oregon.
I know.
At least I don't see it.
No.
So, I mean, realistically, we just need a boat that we can go up and down the coast all day, all week, all month long.
What kind of money are you working with here?
Dude.
So, the conclusion is humpback whales have no rules, and they've definitely taken us by surprise over the last year.
And I think they're the best whale. Sorry. I love when my passengers come out and they're like, I love humpbacks. They're the best. I'm like, thank you. I'm like, but there's killer whales over there. And they're like, never mind. I love killer. I'm just kidding. It's just like,
dang it.
Yeah. Killer whales are tough, man.
Yeah, they are.
Humpbacks can sing their way into your heart.
There you go.
That's from my favorite documentary.
You have to say it like Ewan McGregor.
Yeah, about that.
All right, well, thanks everyone. We'll keep you posted on other weird humpback stuff that we see, but yeah, there's no rules, so they just do what they want.
Caitlin is headed to the future.
The past.
What?
I'm gonna be behind you in time.
Oh yeah. Dang, it is gonna be winter.
Yep.
All right, well, it'll be a sick season in Maui. You're going to have tons of humpbacks and false killer whales. And you're going to see a monk seal on the beach. You're just going to be chilling there. It's going to come up.
Perfect. I love monk seals.
Oh, and a manta ray.
Ooh, yeah. Okay. All right. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye.